Hi, I'm Jacob from ControlByte Company. At ControlByte, we specialize in providing comprehensive and hands-on PLC training that will help you develop your career in automation and robotics. Whether you are an aspiring engineer, student, or simply curious about the world of automation, Factory.io is a powerful simulation software that allows you to design and test your industrial processes in a virtual environment. This is a perfect tool for our PLC training. Now let's get started with the installation process. Don't worry, it's just a breeze. Just follow these steps and you'll have Factory.io up and running in 15 minutes. If you want to start PLC programming, just sign up for our full Siemens PLC programming course. You will find the link down below this video. Now let's get started with Factory.io.
Hello, let's start the next lesson. In this lesson, you will install and start essential part of our programming course, which is simulation environment, Factory.io. Under this video, I have left you a link to this site. It's factory.io.com. Okay, now let's download this software. Click try for free. Factory.io is free of charge for 30 days. You can download and install trial version, which is fully functional. After 30 days, you can subscribe to a certain plan. Now let's download this software. Now you have to fill this form, click start trial, and you'll get an email with download link from Real Games. Before the next step, let's check available subscription plans and licenses. To do this, click buy. Now select the Factory.io edition that you need. Ultimate Edition delivers all the drivers for Siemens, Allen Bradley, Modbus, OPC, UA, protocol, and so on. If you don't need all these drivers, select only Siemens Edition. Drivers from this edition are required to finish this course. If you finish your trial period, which is 30 days long, you can buy a monthly subscription only for 17 euros per month. You can also buy yearly subscription or one-time payment. To finish our course, you can use trial version. Most of our students complete the full course by the end of the trial period. You have 30 days free, and if you want more time, you can subscribe to this version. Now take your time to download and install Factory.io software. If you do this, let's get to the next step. Under this video, I have attached two files. One project from TIA Portal, it's Factory.io template. And the second one, it's Factory.io scene. Please download those two files and start working with me. Firstly, open the TIA Portal project. If you open the project, you can notice some special functions that allow communication with Factory.io environment. In this project, this PLC is configured to communicate with Factory.io environment. I will show you in a minute which configurations are required. Now click on the PLC in the project tree and start PLC sim. Click OK. Okay, download the program to our PLC simulator, start the simulation, and the simulator is in run mode. Okay, now let's go to the second file that you have downloaded from our download section under this video. It's Factory.io scene. Double click on the icon. And now you can see Factory.io scene with one conveyor, one box, and control cabinet with two push buttons. Now we have to configure our driver to communicate with PLC SIM. To do this, go to File, Drivers, click on this tab, and select Siemens S7 PLC SIM. Then go to Configuration, select Model S7-1200. You can also check Auto Connect. Let's go back. And now please check if your mapping is identical to this screen. If not, just drag and drop certain sensors to those input addresses and drag and drop conveyor to output. Okay, now let's check if communication is okay. If your PLC SIM is on, if the PLC simulator is in run mode, you can see green check in this region. Okay, let's go back to the scene. To start the simulation, you have to press play. Now our simulation is alive. You can control certain elements in this scene. For example, you can push buttons or you can manipulate with the boxes. If I push the button, the conveyor will start. Why does it start? It starts because of my program in PLC simulator. I turned off monitoring. I can see online view of my program. Here I have push button and here I have conveyor. If I press the button, the conveyor starts. Okay, now you can pause the video and configure all the things that I have showed you in this tutorial. Please configure the driver, turn on simulation so that you can move your conveyor and the box on it. If you have finished this task, let's move on to the next part of this lesson. Now I will show you some extremely useful tips while working with Factory.io. Let's enlarge the view of this environment and please press stop button on the top. Okay, firstly, I will show you how to move around, how to navigate in this environment. Click File, Options, Controls. Here you can see assigned keys to certain functions like move forward, move backward, move left, move right, and so on. So let's go back to the environment and I will show you how to navigate. If you press A, D, S, W, you will move horizontally, left, right, forward, and backward. Simple. If you press the right mouse button, change the direction of the view, and you can walk around with your keys. It's like in a computer game. When you use your mouse scroll, you can zoom out and zoom in. I'm sure that you will get used to this kind of control in a minute. Okay, excellent. Now I will show you how to build a scene like this. While working in this environment, you switch between two modes, edit mode, like this, and run mode. In edit mode, you can place new elements to your simulation scene. For example, in our scene, we have a conveyor, retroreflective sensor with a little mirror on the opposite side, and a box on the conveyor. In front of our conveyor, there is a control cabinet with two push buttons on it. It is green start button and red stop button. Almost every element in Factory I/O has connected tag. Click View and check sensor tags, actuator tags, and you can check show tags addresses. Click also Dock all tags. Now you have a table with the list of all tags in this scene. We have conveyor tag. If you click on this name, it will be enlighted in this list. Then we have sensor tag. Start button tag. The second start button tag, which is the light. The first one is an input, and the second one is an output. The last one is the stop button light and stop button one. This is the input tag and this is the output tag. Now I will show you how to control this simulation with the list of tags. Press play to switch to run mode. And let's start with the conveyor tag. If you click twice on the name, you can change the name of this element. For example, conveyor entry. Next to the name, you can see the element number. You can change the number of this element. Next to the name, you have little green button. If the simulation is in run mode, you can press this little button. And now your tag and your element is in force mode. In force mode, you can control your actuator by clicking this button. Now, if you want to control the conveyor by the PLC and the interface that we configured, it will be not possible. You have to release the force mode from this tag. And now the interface between the PLC, sim, and factory I/O has influence on this tag. Once again, now my tag conveyor is in force mode. I can control it in factory I/O. If you want to release the force mode, you have to click this button. Next to the force button, there is a little button to simulate failure of the signal. For example, if a contactor in a control cabinet will stuck, our conveyor can be constantly turned on. And now our signal from PLC is not working. You can also change the state of the failure to constantly turn off the signal. Now we can't also control the conveyor. It is constantly turned off. To turn off the failure simulation, you have to click the third time this button. Okay, and now we can switch on our conveyor. Let's move to the next element of our simulation. It is the retroreflective sensor. This sensor has tag in the table on the second row. Switch on run mode and move the box to the end of the conveyor, close to the sensor. Okay. You can see a little LED indicator on the sensor. If the sensor sees the mirror, the signal value is true. It is in high state. You can see it in this spot. This little icon is enlightened. If some object interrupts the sensor's ray, if it will cover the sensor's mirror, the signal will be false and this icon will be dark like this. You should know that you can also force sensor's signal. You have to just press this icon next to the sensor. Now the sensor is forced and it is in high state. If you press once again, it is forced and it is in false state, in low state. To release, you click this button. Now the sensor state is false. If I move a little backward this box, it is now in high state. If I go to drivers, I can map my sensors in this view. I put this sensor to address input 0.2. You can see that this sensor is now in high state. It is enlightened in vivid green. Okay, this is the end of this lesson. Thank you for your hard work and engagement. Let's summarize what we have done during this lesson. You have installed Factory IO environment. You have connected Factory IO simulation environment with PLC simulator. I introduced you into navigation and basic functions of Factory IO. Now you can create your own scenes and modify the scenes that we will deliver during this course. Thank you for watching and let's proceed to the next lesson.
Okay, that's all for now. Thank you for watching. If you are interested in PLC programming, just sign up for the full PLC course with support and certificate. You will find the link down below this video. See you in the full course.